When you run a business, you're not always in office or even available to take a call, let alone track one. So what do you do when you're out in the field working with customers or having meetings? What if only one person is available in the office or no one's available? Maybe it's the weekend and you're missing a lot of calls because it's not during normal business hours. This is perhaps one of the easiest pain points to alleviate using CallRail's call flow features, which we'll be covering in today's video. I'm Adam Markfeld, owner of Paracore, a pay-per-click lead generation agency. This is the 8th video of 10 in my ultimate guide to using CallRail for your PPC marketing. It's a comprehensive video series for using CallRail, a third-party call tracking system, with your pay-per-click marketing. Once you're done with the series, you'll be a call tracking and CallRail guru. If ever you want to jump to a specific section of the video, we've included timestamps in the description below. You can always watch previous videos as a refresher or skip ahead to other videos if I'm covering a topic you're familiar with already. So what is a call flow and why should you care? As the term indicates, a call flow is a path a call takes when someone dials your tracking number. As an example, when a potential customer calls your business, the call flow might route the caller to the appropriate department, depending on the time of day and where they're calling from. This could be the cell phone of someone offsite or simultaneously ringing three people in the department. It could also be as simple as an answering machine, but there are a variety of options at your disposal. Essentially, a call flow gives you tremendous flexibility in how calls are routed to different people in your or your client's organization. Today, we're going to talk about how to set one up and the different options at your disposal in CallRail. There are several different ways to set up call flows depending on how you want to forward the calls that are coming into your business. It's a simple process, so let's jump right in. The call flow feature can be accessed and set up in the numbers screen of CallRail. When creating a new call flow, it's best to name it something specific to its purpose. For example, call only adds call flow. We'll cover each call flow feature listed, but first a word about recording phone calls. You can turn on the feature to record calls. However, be mindful that the laws are different in each state. By turning on call recording, you'll want to give the caller explicit notifications that their call may be recorded for quality assurance. You can do this in the call flow greeting feature. You can set up to play a default recording or play a recording of your own voice. You can also preview the message to experience what the caller will hear. Call flow greetings can be set up even if you're not using call recording. The first and most basic call flow option is the dial option. The dial feature allows you to forward phone calls from your tracking number to your cell phone or another number. In the dial settings, you have an option to prevent voicemails and automated systems from answering a call. The option allows you to choose whether or not the caller will connect to an automated system or simply go to the next step automatically. If you don't select this option, callers might be taken into an automated system and not enter your subsequent call flow steps. That might not be good if you're wanting the caller to progress through your system. Next, designate what happens if the call isn't answered in a set amount of time. For example, if no one answers the call within 20 seconds, send the call to the next step. You don't have to use every option in this video for callers, but if you want to provide as many options as possible to callers, there are no limits. Let's talk about another call flow option called Simulcall. The Simulcall feature rings multiple phones simultaneously. Whoever answers first gets the call. You can also start a call flow this way if you have multiple employees in charge of answering calls. You have two options with the Simulcall feature. You can prevent voicemails and automated messages, which we just covered, and route previous callers to the number that answered the last time that specific caller called. These are straightforward options, but if someone still isn't available to answer, pick the time frame from the drop-down menu and set up the next call flow step. The round robin option lets you set the order in which a person or employee will receive the call. You can have it progress to the next number on the list if the designated recipient doesn't pick up. For example, if Harold doesn't pick up the call in 20 seconds, it will go to Sarah next, and so on. Again, you have the option to prevent voicemails and automated systems. In this option, you can also route calls using a weighted distribution instead of evenly distributing the calls to a pool of recipients. You might use a weighted distribution if one of your recipients is training, new, or has a dual role, and you don't want them to receive a full load of calls. Another option that can happen at any point in the call from beginning to end is the menu option. For example, you can start the caller off with a menu option or give you a menu option after an initial transfer has taken place. The menu option is where the caller gets a list of options from an interactive phone menu. For example, press 1 for sales, 2 for support, and so on. Just like with the greeting call flow feature, you can record your message or use the default recorded voice. After you've listed all the potential options, you can specify where the call should go. For example, if the caller presses 1, forward the call using the dial feature to the sales department. Or you can use another call flow feature instead. Many companies have phone systems that offer a similar menu option, but CallRail's other features allow you to take routing to the next level. Perhaps one of the most beneficial call flow features on the list of choices is the schedule feature, which allows you to determine where your callers will be routed based on the time of day. For example, choose weekends from the drop-down menu, then choose all day or specify the hours. Then choose where you want the caller to go. You might want calls routed to a call center on the weekends, but your employees during the weekdays. Or maybe it's the holidays and you send them to voicemail. Next up, the Geo-Routing call flow feature allows you to handle calls by the caller's area code or even zip code. For area codes, you can cluster by city or state location and include as many area codes as that city or state location may have. For example, location one might be all of the greater Phoenix area codes. Then if the caller's area code matches location one, you can send it to a specific recipient, simultaneously ring multiple lines, or perhaps do a round robin. On the other hand, if your calls are tracked by zip code and you have multiple business locations, you can have the closest location take the call. Or perhaps you're remote salespeople, so you'll want to route the call to the closest location up to, let's say, 100 miles. So you set up the call flow and route all calls from zip code 85282 to the Phoenix sales rep. Responsive routing is another call flow feature that allows you to route a call by specific criteria such as first-time caller. You can route calls by repeat caller, source, keyword, active page, landing, refer, campaign, previous lead status, or number name. You can add multiple options and specify where to route the call on each. Something you might choose to do is tag a first-time caller as a qualified lead using the tag call flow option. You can literally do any combination of potential options so callers always reach the right person in your client's organization. The last two choices, voicemail and hangup, are self-explanatory and typically your last option because they end the call flow. For voicemail, again, you can record your own message or have the robot do it by typing in the message you want read. You do have the option for voicemail transcriptions for an additional cost of 40 cents per transcription. Once the caller has reached voicemail, the last step would be to hang up the call. So there you have it. That's your overview of setting up CallRail call flow for routing your calls. Make sure you check out our next video about how to use CallRail for customer service improvement. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button and make sure you click that red subscribe button below the video to receive updates on this series and more. Also, we'd like to hear from you. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below and I'll see you in the next video.